Welcome to the annual Veterans Day program at WDC Schools. Due to the high COVID numbers in our community, the Veterans Day program will again be held virtually this year. While we would love to have all of our veterans and community members join us at the school in person, it is just not possible at this time. However, Veterans Day is simply too important to let pass without paying our respects to veterans past and present. We do this every year to honor our veterans, those men and women who have bravely served our country and placed the well-being of our great nation and country ahead of their personal well-being. Also, Veterans Day is an important time for our young people to learn about sacrifice and commitment and the price of freedom. And because of that, this program and Veterans Day in general provides a powerful educational opportunity for our students. Veterans Day is also very personal to me because my dad served in the infantry in the Philippines and Japan during World War II. His service was a huge part of who he was as a person, and I admired him deeply for all that he did for the United States and his sacrifice to fight evil in the world. His time in the infantry was very difficult, but he was proud of his country, and he was proud of his service, and I am proud to be his son. I'm also proud to say that all WDC students will watch this program in their classrooms on Veterans Day. Veterans, thank you for your service, and thank you for joining us today. I am now honored to introduce the VFW Post 3922 Color Guard with the presentation of the colors.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
why I'm proud to be an American by Bristol Wynn. I'm proud to be an American because I have freedom and can make my own choices. I thank the past and present veterans for giving me freedom. America is home to many people. In America, I feel that I can say something and not get punished. I thank the men and women who fought for our rights and freedom. We will always remember, we will always be proud, we will always be prepared, so we will always be free, Ronald Reagan once spoke. I don't think proud is a good way to say how I feel about America. I feel the appropriate way is by using the words grateful and privileged. I thank the soldiers for having courage, standing tall, and fighting for our freedom. One of the most special veterans I thank is someone I call Grandpa. My Grandpa Mike was one of the brave men who served for our country. I'm thankful to have public education, churches, stores, and many more places to enjoy. America has never made me lose my faith in home. Living in America gives me many opportunities. I can never be a more proud American. I value America with all my heart. Harry S. Truman once said, "America was not built on fear. America was built on courage, on imagination, and on unbeatable determination to do the job at hand." Us as Americans can watch the television and see that we have the rights that others never got. Our troops risked their lives for the freedom we exercise for. So I stand with my chest out and a smile on my face when I pledge to the American flag because I am so proud to be an American. Thank you.
Well, I'm proud to be an American by Caden Clark. I'm proud to be an American because of all the hard work our veterans have done for all of us. We fought for what we deserve. We don't only fight for us, but we help other countries in need. I'm not just proud to be an American, but I'm thankful, grateful, and lucky to be an American. Our veterans have risked their lives, some even lost their lives for us. Some don't realize how long our veterans work to keep us safe and how hard some people work to keep us safe. I think we should give thanks to all of them for what they've done for us. I'm proud to be an American because of all the stuff we are lucky to have that a lot of other places don't have. I know America was attacked September 11, 2001. And I know a lot of people were hurt and a lot died, but I'm proud of all the first responders that risked their lives to help all those who were hurt. I could not be more happy or lucky to be an American citizen. I am not just proud of our first responders, but I'm also proud of the citizens that helped and are helping. I'm proud that we can stay out at night. We can go where we want to, and we can live how we want to. And that's why I'm proud to be an American.
Why I'm proud to be an American by Aubrey Van Runkle. I would like to start by saying the First Amendment has given me the right to my own opinion in this essay. I am proud to be an American because I feel safe in my home. I know the soldiers and police officers, whether on the front lines or behind the desks, will do their best to protect my family, friends, neighbors, classmates, and this country. My granddad was one who served 20 years in the Air Force. These heroes sacrificed their time, family, and sometimes life for us. They don't even know us. If there were not men and women willing to protect us all, we would not have the chance to live the life we are today. I'm proud of all who serve.
Proud to be an American by Tegan Robinson. I am proud to be an American because we are the land of the free, giving us endless opportunities for freedom and happiness. This is the home of the brave, where our strong and brave soldiers fight to keep our freedom. I also am proud to be an American because we are one nation and stand together no matter the challenges. We stand together as a country and learn new skills. We can work hard at our dreams without limits, and thanks to all soldiers for protecting our country and sacrificing your lives for us. We all appreciate you, and that is why this is the land of the free.
We stand together, gaining ground each day. Why, I am proud to be an American by Hudson Hathaway. I am proud to be an American because all citizens are equal no matter your culture, skin color, and gender. They are all the same, which is a huge reason why I'm proud to be an American. Also, women can vote, which is very good. We have a very strong military, including Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, and Coast Guard. They have done an amazing job keeping us safe and free. It is unbelievable. I'm so happy. Another reason I am proud to be an American is our country is free. When we say free, that doesn't mean we can purchase America for free. It means that we can make our own decisions and have a say in things. For instance, we can vote, which is freedom. We can wear what we want. We can choose what school to go to. Thanks again, veterans, for your hard work. You all are real heroes. We appreciate you. Thank you.
Why I am proud to be an American by Emma Betterman. I am proud to be an American because I have an amazing family and friends, and also the best teachers. I love how many people sacrificed for us to have freedom and rights for women and men to be equal. I am also proud to be an American because we have rights to go to school and buy food so we can feed our family. In a book my teacher read to my class and me, this girl didn't have a right to go to school and speak up about how it is unfair for girls and women. She finally spoke up about it, but she got hurt badly. But her book and her words are traveling around the world and giving people hope. When I grow up, I want to join the Army to fight and protect America and everyone in it. If I can't, I'll be happy that I am free and honor those who have lost their lives for us. Thank you.
Why I'm Proud to Be an American by Addison Hilka. This is a question that could be answered in many ways, but to me, America is the place I call home. It's where I was born and has shaped me into the person I am today. There's so many things that make up my idea of why I'm proud to be an American. America is about opportunity. Individuals can do great things in America that they may not have been able to do anywhere else. America is about fulfilling the ultimate dream. It's about equality, no matter what they may look like on the outside. It's about democracy, lending a hand to those in need, selflessness, and coming together as one. Many others making sacrifices for America and their loved ones, and that's why I'm proud to be an American.
I am proud to be an American because of all the rights that we have. We get to go to school, wear what we want, and get to choose what job we want instead of having one picked out for us. I'm thankful for all the sacrifices that were made so that we can live free. I want to remember all the lives that were lost. They had to be cold and miss their families, and we get to do sports and hang out with our friends. I am proud to be an American because of all the unselfish people who got us freedom. Saying thank you is not enough. We should donate things to them and also have suppers with them. There are so many things we can do to show gratitude. I feel bad for the families who had to go through loss and other sacrifices. We should always be thankful and give appreciation. Thank you.
A quilt of valor was presented to Bernie St. Peter on November 2nd by members of the Homespun Quilt Club in Wadena. Bernie served in the U.S. Army from 1971 to 1973 as an infrared radar repairman. Bernie grew up in Poposky, Minnesota, and graduated from Bemidji High School. He started his career as a teacher in Lomond, Minnesota, on the Rainy River near International Falls in 1973. Bernie started teaching in Wadena in 1978 and stayed until his retirement in 2007. In 1989, Bernie started the annual Veterans Day program that is held at WDC after he saw a need to honor veterans and educate the students on the sacrifices that our veterans have made for our country. Bernie and his wife Betty currently reside in Wadena and have two daughters that graduated from WDC, Suzette from the class of 1991 and Michelle from the class of 1993. Presenting the quilt to Bernie are Homespun Quilt members Sandy Rentz, Barb Tennis, and Linda Macklenburg.
Thank you. If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the
a lot of good people earned it. And this is how I learned it.
You're beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties.
Those whose uniform is good. tears, finding in their love of freedom, thou art stronger than their fears. Sing a song for unsung heroes, sing from sea to shining sea, as the faithful sang before you, sing a song of liberty. Thank you.
The Patriot's Pen Program is a national patriotic essay contest sponsored by the Veterans of Foreign Wars and its auxiliary. Locally, the contest was open to students in grades 7 and 8 in Wadena-Deer Creek, Verndale, Bertha Hewitt, Staples Motley, and Sabika schools. A special thank you is extended to the instructors who helped with the Patriot's Pen contest. First, second, and third place prizes were awarded at each school with submitted entrants. Entries were judged on how well the writer developed this year's theme, which is, "How can I be a good American?" And a special thank you is extended to Mr. Todd Hale for his help with this program. From the 9 7th and 8th grade entries in the Patriot's Pen Essay Contest, 3 awards were given. Placing third and receiving a certificate and $20 is Jonathan Hockert. And Jonathan, would you come to receive your certificate?
Congratulations. Thank you.
Placing second and receiving a certificate and $25 is Fallon Simon.
Congratulations. Thank you.
And placing first and receiving a certificate and $30 is Emma Winnegar.
Congratulations. I need you to stay here. Yes.
Emma was also selected as the second place winner from VFW Post 3922 of Wadena and receives an award certificate and $35. Congratulations to each one of the winners, and thank you very much for entering the contest. And if you're eligible, I would encourage you to enter again next year or to enter the Voice of Democracy contest, which is available for students in grades 9 through 12. Thank you very much. I think each of you deserves a round of applause. Established in 1947, the Voice of Democracy program is a national patriotic audio essay contest sponsored by the Veterans of Foreign Wars and its auxiliary. Each year, over 40,000 high school students enter the contest, vying for the top national prize of $30,000. Over $2.1 million are awarded annually to Voice of Democracy winners. Locally, Elmer Goshi Post 3922 invited students in grades 9 through 12 in Wadena-Deer Creek, Verndale, Bertha Hewitt, Sabika, and Staples Motley schools to submit essays for the Voice of Democracy scholarship contest. Entrants wrote and then recorded for judging a 3 to 5 minute essay on the theme, America, where do we go from here? All entrants remained anonymous to the judges, and the audio essays were judged on theme interpretation and development, as well as on oral delivery. First, second, and third place prizes are offered at each school, with the first, second, and third places prizes of $150, $125, and $100 respectively. Customarily, prize awards would be announced at a program at the VFW club rooms in Wadena on the night of the Veterans Day supper. However, because of the high number of COVID cases in the area, no program will be held on Veterans Day. Therefore, it is my pleasure to award those prizes now. This year, Wadena-Deer Creek had 6 entrants. Keisha Chandler, Anna Gu, Katie Leesburg, Chloe Leesburg, Susanna Sneeden, and Seth Strowing. On behalf of the VFW and Auxiliary, I would like to thank the entrants for their thoughtful essays, as well as Mrs. Lois Schultz, who helped promote the Voice of Democracy program. Placing third from Wadena-Deer Creek High School and receiving an award certificate and $100 is Chloe Leesburg. Placing second and receiving an award of $125 is Susanna Sneeden.
Congratulations, Susanna.
And placing first from Wadena-Deer Creek High School and receiving an award certificate and $150 is Seth Strowing. This year, there were a total of 20 students who submitted audio essays to VFW Post 3922 for the Voice of Democracy contest. The winner's audio essay is forwarded to the district for further competition and judging. The post winner receives an additional prize of $250. This year's post winner was Madison Schmitz from Ferndale. One more prize that we give each year for our patriotic essay contest. The patriotic essay entrants are entered into a random drawing for three quilts made by the VFW Auxiliary. And I'm pleased to announce that one of those quilts was won by Anna Gu. So Anna, would you come up and receive your quilt? Excuse me.
Thank you.
So this is your quilt. So congratulations. I have a plastic bag that you can put it in. Okay, thank you. Again, I would like to thank all of you for entering and continued success. If you are eligible, please enter the contest again next year. Thank you very much.
Today's program and leading the WDC choirs. Thank you to elementary music teacher Nora Long and her students for their part in today's program. Thank you to Kyle Gilsine and Grace Gallant for producing the program. Thank you to the homespun quilters, the VFW Color Guard, Lisa Weniger for accompanying the choir, the 5th through 12th grade choir students, our essay winners, and to Josephine Pinella for playing taps. But most of all, thank you veterans. We owe so much to you that we can't possibly sum it up with words. Thank you for joining us for today's program. I wish everyone a safe and healthy holiday season.